Welcome to another session in Golang on the design pattern. In this session, I will explain you the what, why, and how of the Singleton design pattern in Go. So let's start with the what of the Singleton design pattern. Singleton design pattern is a creational design pattern. This pattern is used when only a single instance of this struct should exist in Golang, and this single instance is called the singleton object. Now there are two ways in real time we use this pattern, as then these ways are below. So the first way is the singleton pattern with this eager initialization. In the eager initialization, instance of the singleton class is created much before it is actually required. Mostly it is done on the system startup, but it has a disadvantage that the object is created even though the R application might not be using it after the startup. Now, the other way is the singleton design pattern with lazy initialization. With lazy initialization, we create the instance only when it's needed and not when the class or the object is loaded. In this tactic, the delaying of the creation of the object, the calculation of the value, or some other expensive process until the first time it is needed. So basically in this, we'll create the singleton object whenever our application will go up for the first time. And with the lazy initialization, we'll create the object when the object will be needed for the first time in the application. Now there are some important points that has to be considered before creating the singleton pattern. Now, the first one is singleton object can have only one instance, and that instance should be globally accessible. Now, this is to prevent the calling of the object creation again and again. So basically we create the object once and then we assign that object to a global variable and make that global variable accessible across the application, so that any object can, any class, object, or any package within the program can access that global variable and make use of that. Now, the second point is outer packages objects should be prevented to create the instance of the singleton class, because the outer packages or the outer calls may be out of the scope of your application hosting environment, where the singleton instance and the different counters may not be available to it. So that's where your singleton pattern may fail. So that's why the outer should be prevented to create the instance of the singleton class. Now let's come to the why of the singleton pattern. So to understand the why, let's understand the real-time example cases where the singleton pattern or the singleton object can be used. The first is the DB instance. So we only want to create only one instance of the DB object, and that instance will be used throughout the application. Since creation of the DB object and DB connection is a heavy process, because we are making a connection to the COM component that's outside the scope of our application normally. Now, the second thing is the logger instance. So only one instance of logger should be instantiated with the application, and then the same instance should be used across the application, because obviously within the logging, we will use the instance of the logger across the application to use the logging here and there. Now, the third point is the configuration file. So this is another potential candidate for the singleton pattern, because our application may need some static configuration, like reading the configuration from the file whenever the application loads. One example can be a web API where the application will load certain modules based on the static configuration file, and multiple users hitting the same API should not create the instance of the same configuration file again and again, rather than only one instance should be created. Same is the case with the cache. Now let's come to the how of the singleton pattern. Now, so in the program, since it will be difficult to show you the real-time scenario where multiple packages are calling the application configuration struct, so I'll mimic the same via calling the get instance method of the struct 100 times in a loop via Go routines, and we'll validate the single object creation via global counter that will increase its value if there are more instances those are created. So let me remove this to show you the example. Let me remove the theory part of it, and to save time, I've already written down the program for you. I have copied the program here for you. So let's start with the line number one of the program, and which is essentially line number 13 here. So here I have created a mutex. So to prevent the race conditions, because I will be using Go routines in this, as I've told previously, so I have used the mutex. Now this is my configuration struct. that the name of that configuration struct is config, and it is not exportable because the first letter is in the lowercase. Now it may have certain configuration variable that will be required to be set when my application will load. Now this is the counter. The value of this counter will denote how many instances are created across the application. Now this is the global variable that I have created for the of type struct config. Now I have created a method called getConfigInstance that returns the instance of the config. Now on next line, I'm checking if the instance is nil, that means there is no instance created till now, then lock the mutex. Next line, I'm saying defer. I'm using defer because whenever my application will give an error due to any line within this function, I want this mutex to be unlocked, so that my application will not be in a deadlock condition. Now, again, I am checking if single instance is equal to null. I'll explain you why I'm checking this condition twice in the program. So if this condition also satisfied, then I'll say, okay, create a single instance now. And the counter is the value of the counter that essentially is being initialized with one here. Now here, once the condition is satisfied, then I'm creating the instance of the struct, incrementing the counter, and these are the else condition. This else condition is if this will fail, then it will say that it is already created, and if this will fail, then it is saying already created, and finally we are returning the single instance that is created here. And now this single instance is a global variable across the package. Now in the main program, what I am doing is I have created a for loop that will start with 0 and will go till 99. So I'm creating a loop that will run 100 times and will call the getConfigInstance method 100 times, and there is a go. That means I'm calling it via go routines. That means this method will be called concurrently. Now here, I'm calling fmt.scanl because I do not want my program to exit without me pressing the enter button in the screen. So I'm using the scanln function here. It is similar to scan, but it stops scanning at a new line after the final item. Here must be a new line or end of file. So now let's come back to the program and let me explain you what exactly I'm checking here and here. So within the first line, this single config instance is equal to null. This is to prevent the expensive lock operation every time the get instance method is called. So basically this is the check because I do not want to have the lock operation called again and again when the get instance method is called. After that, after this lock operation, what I'm doing is I'm doing a check again. Now this check is to make sure that if more than one goroutine bypasses the first check, that is this first check, so then only one goroutine should be able to create the singleton instance. Otherwise, each of the goroutine will create its own instance and our singleton pattern creation will fail. So that's the reason I'm checking it here again. Let me run this program for you now. And I'll say run main.go, you see. Now what it has done is, it says creating single instance now, and the counter value is one because one is what we have instantiated. And now it has called the getInstance method 100 times concurrently because we are using the goroutine. This is kind of mimicking the same scenario that happens in the real-time application. So it says single instance already created one. That means it is inside this condition. It is inside this condition always. And it says created one, returning that one, returning that one, returning that one, returning that one, and that is all. This means that once the program has created this single config instance of the struct in this line 28, after that, it is not instantiating it the struct again and again, rather than it is returning the same global variable instance every time. Now let me show you. So currently only one condition is satisfied, that is this one. Now let me run the program again and let's see what happens. So again, you see this time the second condition also is being satisfied. That means first it check, okay, if the single instance is not nil, that means it will come here. It says instance is already created, you see. And now this is because the first time this condition was never satisfied, because Go routine has its own behavior. It decides based on how much time each and every Go routine is having and how much time lapse each and every Go routine will take to finish their job up. So it's totally depending upon the Go runtime of how it executes the Go routine internally. So that behavior is not depending upon us. So this is how you create the Go routine singleton pattern in Golang. And all the code and the program associated that I have shown you here will be present in the GitLab link that will be present in the description part. Thank you very much, guys. And at last, please do like, subscribe, and comment if you really like my videos.